Dear friends, welcome to the Ven World Connect YouTube channel. First, I would like to thank all of you for your wonderful response to earlier video presentations uploaded on the Ven World channel. Today, I am going to talk about the topic managing layerbirds in summer season. And in today's presentation, we will discuss about some management practices and nutritional practices which will help to reduce the summer stress on birds. So, as you know that providing optimal environment for better egg production is very important, and it starts with the construction of a good layer set, as it will provide comfort to the birds for better productivity. Then, climate and temperature variations on day-to-day basis creates lot of stress on the birds, which in turn causes poor performance of the bird, and temperature above and below the optimum, that means thermoneutral zone, causes poor flock performance. So in simple, as temperature goes up, flock performance goes down. The high temperature in summer increases water consumption, respiration rate, then surface body temperature and stress. All this has this is increased in summer, and feed intake, egg production, pulse rate, thyroid size and activity, blood calcium level, interior egg quality, bird body weight, blood pressure, egg weight, egg shell quality, egg shell thickness, all goes down with the increasing temperatures or in summer season. And in summer season, which produces heat stress, causes economical losses to the poultry farm. And this is due to increased mortality, poor feed consumption, then lower feed efficiency like poor FCR or more feed per egg, drop in egg production, increase in egg breakage, heat stress also makes birds susceptible to infectious diseases like respiratory, digestive problems, then some of the immunosuppressive diseases. And heat stress makes the birds more susceptible to such diseases also. Along with that, it also lowers the immunity, as well as it causes some metabolic disorders in the birds, resulting into poor performance of the bird. And to avoid this heat stress effect on the birds, we need to make more investment in the shed, some equipments like fans, coolers, sprinklers, foggers, and this also puts additional burden in the feed cost, because we need to add some of the feed additives to make the heat stress effect less. And these addition of all these feed additives or supplements increases the cost of the feed. Before going into the detail to the measures of the heat, measures to be taken in the heat stress, I would like to give you some information related to birds' characteristics, as birds have some peculiar characteristics like absence of sweat glands. Relatively, they also have relatively deeper body temperatures, and the feathers or plumage provides effective insulation to their body during winter, during summer, both the season, and the birds have higher rate of feed digestion also, almost 3 hours feed is digested. And due to this higher digestion of feed, more heat is produced in the bird's body as a byproduct of the essential metabolic processes. And these metabolic processes are involved in maintenance, growth, and egg production of the bird. This heat production in the bird is dependent on many factors like body weight, species and breed, then level of production, level of feed intake, feed quality, and activity of the bird in the shed. Then this heat produced in the bird's body needs to be thrown out of the body. And this heat loss from the bird's body is by radiation, convection, evaporation and conduction. These are the four means of heat loss from the bird's body. And in that, evaporative heat loss is very important in tropical countries or in high temperatures. And it is more effective when the humidity is not too high. Then only evaporative heat loss is effective. There needs to be a perfect balance between what? The heat production and the heat loss from the bird's body for better well-being of the bird. And this heat is liberated as a byproduct of the metabolic processes, but these processes are not constant. They are always keep on changing. Sometimes there will be more heat generation, sometimes there will be less heat generation. And this heat liberation during the metabolic processes is affected by oxygen intake, feed intake, and activity of the bird. And increase in any of these three will lead to greater heat production in the bird, deep sections of the bird. And if this heat is not liberated from the bird's body, then the bird's body temperature increases, which causes heat stress. But birds are always trying to fight with the situation. And typically, birds try to adjust to the increasing environmental temperature. The bird's response to increasing temperature involves first, there will be alarming situation. And this alarming situation is at 30 degrees centigrade and above. Then there is a stage of adaptation where bird tries to adapt to the situation of increasing temperature. And normally it is at 35 degrees centigrade and above temperatures. And the third phase in the response of bird to the heat is stage of fatigue or exhaustion. That means the bird is not able to cope up with the increasing temperature, and this situation generally it is at 38 degrees centigrade and above temperature. Then what happens when these birds are not unable to manage the high temperature? We need to provide the birds help by reducing the temperature inside the cell by using farm shed management to reduce the temperature, water management, nutritional measures, which can elevate the heat stress. And also we need to do disease prevention by proper biosecurity measures at the farm so that bird will be in a better position to fight with the heat stress. Then, first of all, we will discuss about the various measures to be taken to minimize the impact of heat on birds by adjusting the things in the poultry shed environment, or how we can make the changes in the poultry shed, and that changes will help the bird to fight with the increasing temperature. So first is using a 4 feet wide gunny bag or jute bag curtain strip at bird's level with water drip from top of the curtain, so that drip water will pour on the curtain and the curtain will become wet, and the whatever the air coming from outside will pass through this cool curtain, which will provide cool air to the bird. Then next is use of circulatory fans for having air movement inside the cell. So they will also help to keep the air moving inside the cell. Then third thing, we can use roof ventilators for hot air movement outside the cell, as hot air is usually lighter in weight and it is always at top of the cell so that it can be easily thrown out of the cell. Then we can do thatching of the roof also, as shown in this particular picture. You can see that very nicely thatching has been done in this poultry shed. So we can have thatching with sugarcane leaves or some grass also. Then we can do whitewash on roof of the rooftop It also helps to reduce the inside set temperature by almost 7 to 8 degrees centigrade. And for this particular whitewash, we can add, we can use 10 kg of lime, 2 kg of cement in 25 liters of water. Very simple. 10 kg lime powder, 2 kg cement, 25 liters of water, and you can paint it on the top of the roof so that this white color will reflect maximum heat and avoid entry of hot air inside the shed. Then we can have these gunny curtains of 4 to 5 feet at the bird's level. These curtains will help to prevent the hot air draft directly on the birds. So this is also very useful thing we can take at farm. Then we can install the foggers if we do not have a problem related to electricity and availability of the water. We can use foggers and inside the shed, we can fit the foggers like this between the lines, or sometimes we can have some own ideas, like we can fit it to the feeding trolley and these foggers will directly spray the fine mist of water on birds directly, which will help them to keep cool. Also, sprinklers can be a good solution on rooftop to help to reduce the temperature inside the shed, and sprinklers can be fitted at 10 feet distance from each other. So these are the some of the things which can be done at the shed level, especially so that it is birds can have better climate, comfortable climate inside the shed. Then, as we all know, water is an important nutrient for the birds. Under normal condition, birds will drink 2.5 to 3 times more water than the feed consumption. But in summer, birds drink much more water than this normal. As in summer, birds do a lot of panting to bring down the body temperature, and this panting leads to higher than normal loss of water. So water should be available to the birds all the time so that birds will drink the water comfortably and they will avoid dehydration because of this evaporative water loss. Then for this, do not fill the shed tank completely. Also do flushing two to three times so that hot standing water inside the pipelines will be taken out, and if possible, or if your water tank is outside the shed, then you can cover it with gunny bag, or you can make a shed for that tank so that water in the tank will remain cool. Then birds should have access to cool water always. You can add 0.2% salt and electrolytes, 1 to 2 gram per liter, which are commercially available in water to maintain the electrolyte balance. Vitamin C also helps to reduce the heat stress, as addition of vitamin C in water is more beneficial than adding of vitamin C in the feed. So these measures we can also undertake. And one more important thing, flushing of the water pipelines at regular intervals of 15 days or 20 days and cleaning of water tank once in 15 days is also helpful, because all these flushing and cleaning of the water tank will help to remove the biofilm from the pipeline so that there will be no chances of infection to the birds coming from the water. And one more important thing I want to tell you, that the pipeline is coming from the main tank to the shed tank, and if it runs in the sunlight, then the water inside the pipe becomes hot. So you can cover this particular pipeline, which is in the sunlight, with some jute cloth or gunny cloth or any other cloth, and sprinkle some water over it during the afternoon hours so that the water inside the pipe will remain cool. Otherwise, anytime hot water is coming from main tank to the shed tank, or it gets heated during the process. Then managing of drinker system management is also important Ensure that nipple drinkers have sufficient water flow and sufficient drinker place is provided to the birds and all nipples are functioning properly. Because we give lot of medicines through the water or sometimes hard water also causes nipples to function improperly. Keeping water temperature below 25 degrees centigrade helps to maintain higher water intake, which in turn increases feed consumption, whereas water temperature above 30 degrees centigrade can have negative impact on water intake as well as on feed intake. So we need to take into consideration all these things. So after the water management, I would like to go to the one of the most important thing which is affecting the productivity in summer, that is feed management. As feed consumption is very important to the birds, as birds do not eat feed during the daytime, right from the 10 a.m. or to up to 4 p.m. birds do not eat the feed. So feeding birds early in the morning and evening will help to maintain the feed consumption. And we can try midnight feeding also can be done, and it is done generally 3 hours after we switch off the lights in the evening. Observe the feeding times to ensure the birds are eating enough feed to support the egg production. Then one more important thing is that do not make frequent changes in the feed formulation and feed ingredients also. Also, sudden changes in feed will affect the feed consumption and egg production. So make whatever changes you want to make in the feed formulation, make well before the start of the summer season. Then, while considering feed management, one important thing, another important thing is that maintaining the energy balance is very important for egg production, as energy drives the egg formation. In that case, body fat reserves plays important role in energy balance. And due to less feed consumption, bird gets less energy, which reduces egg weight and egg numbers. And energy requirement for maintenance is always a priority because birds will fulfill the energy requirement first. And in that case, addition of fat or oils in feed increases energy in the feed, increases the palatability, and addition of fat or oil also have less heat increment. That means less feed will be generated when we give energy in the form of oils. In feed, proper energy level maintenance is essential because energy requirement of birds can be fulfilled by increasing feeding times, midnight feeding, or weight feeding. Sometimes we pour some B complex or liver tonics over the top of the feeding channels so that the birds can feed, get weight, and the birds will eat that weight feed. And then by doing so, your problem related to less feed consumption can be handled. Then further, after maintaining energy balance, further important thing is that fortification of the feed to maintain feed consumption, what we can do in this case. So for this, supplementation of feed with amino acid in regards to feed intake is necessary. We can replace D-L-methionine with MHA or B10 to some extent, then increasing calcium and phosphorus content of the feed, replacing 40 to 50% of salt with soda bicarb will help to maintain the electrolyte balance also, and will also help to maintain the egg cell quality. Then vitamin C, vitamin A, vitamin E also can be given to the birds through feed, and we can increase the vitamin and mineral premixes by 25%, or you can increase them by considering the feed consumption drop. Suppose it is 110, it came down to 100 grams, then accordingly you can reduce 10% or 12%. You can increase the 12% or 10% of the vitamins and mineral premixes. Then feed supplements like probiotics, phytobiotics, acidifiers, dextrose also helps in alleviating the heat stress. And a good mycotoxin binder should always be added to the poultry feed, as in summer season the bird's immunity goes down, and due period any problem can easily come in the flock. So toxin binder addition will help to keep the toxicity away. Then another important thing in connection to the feed management is that heat stress has an effect on XL quality, as panting causes increased loss of carbon dioxide from the lungs, and this increases blood pH, producing respiratory alkalosis. And this respiratory alkalosis reduces the activity of the carbonic anhydrase enzyme, which is essential to form the XL. And in the cell glands, what happens in the cell glands? Reduced secretion of calcium and carbonate ions results in poor XL. So by the virtue of this panting, CO2 loss is there, or carbon dioxide gas is lost from the lungs, blood pH increases, respiratory alkalosis is there, and reduced availability of secretion of calcium and carbonate ions give rise to poor XL quality. So for better XL quality in summer, adjusting the calcium requirement as per the feed consumption is very important. Whatever the feed consumption, 90 gram, you can keep accordingly 4.7%, or 100 gram 4.2%, 110 gram you can keep 3.8, 120 you can keep 3.2, up to 40 weeks these figures. And after 40 weeks, normally we need to maintain all these figures. That means up to 40 weeks, birds should get minimum 4.2 grams of calcium per bird per day. And after 40 weeks, minimum birds should get 4.5 grams of calcium per bird per day. So calcium adjustment is important as feed consumption goes down. And along with calcium, phosphorus maintenance is also important, because phosphorus plays important role in the XL quality. And we need to keep in mind that phosphorus requirement goes on decreasing as the bird's age increases, not like in the calcium. Calcium requirement goes on increasing along with the age increase. But in phosphorus, it is completely reverse. So up to 40 weeks, normally 420 milligram per day per bird calcium is required. And after 40 weeks, 380 to 400 milligram per day per bird available phosphorus should be provided to the bird for better XL quality. Then after the feed management, again I am coming to some managemental practices like ventilation. As ventilation cannot be neglected, as it plays a key role in minimizing the effect of heat, as it removes hot air from the cell to outside. And increase the air movements helps the birds to lose excess body heat. So ventilation is important. Very important. For that, we can have circulatory fans, roof ventilators, all that keeps the air movement. And by that, keeping the or maintaining the air movement well inside the shed, we can remove the heat from the shed. Now I will discuss about some general managemental points which can be done during the summer season, which are record the shed temperature, keep the thermometer, maintain the temperature during the different times of the day so that we can have an idea what time temperature is increasing. Or then all operations like vaccination, medication, debaking, shifting, weighing, grading, or any other operation you want to carry out inside, even repair maintenance of the shed should be carried out during early morning or evening only. During the day time or during from 10 to 11 a.m. up to 4 p.m. do not disturb the birds inside the shed. Also maintain good antibody titers against diseases like Newcastle, infectious bronchitis, so that there will not be problem related to this, because these diseases are mostly we are observing these diseases during the summer season. So we need to maintain good antibody titers by doing the vaccination right before the start of the summer season. For that, you can follow midday vaccination also. That will help to maintain the proper antibody titers against all diseases like Newcastle and infectious bronchitis. then good antimycoplasma prevention program well in place every 6 weeks, 5 weeks, depending upon the infection load at your farm. We can have, we should design a antimycoplasma program. Then mycotoxin, I already told you about the mycotoxin problems in the summer season. So good mycotoxin binder should be there in the feed all the times. And we cannot forget biosecurity, as biosecurity will help to prevent the diseases entering from the site. Then another thing, we can have summary of all these nutritional measures which we can take at the farm, like addition of vitamin C at 250 mg in the addition of vitamin C 250 mg per kg, and soda bicarb for better XL quality. Monitor total calcium, total sodium and chloride intake of the bird. Ensure adequate chloride levels in the feed when you are providing sodium through soda bicarbonate. Otherwise, what happens? Sodium goes up and chloride goes down, and that disturbs the dietary electrolyte balance, which is very important for XL quality. Then increase number of feedings. You can have more number of feedings during morning hours, evening hours. Provide feed during the morning and evening hours only. Maintain particle size of the feed, proper particle size of the feed. Then vitamin C, I already told you. Then keep drinking water as cool as possible. Do the water sanitation on regular basis so that no infection can creep into the flock through water. And do not make sudden changes in feed, because making sudden changes in feed can be detrimental for the bird's performance. Then increase energy levels by adding fat or oil. Limit the crude fiber levels, because more of the crude fiber levels will also not be beneficial for the birds, as it increases the problems related to loose dropping and all. And reduce protein level, but maintain the levels of essential amino acids like digestible methionine 400 mg, digestible lysine 720 mg, and digestible threonine 500 mg. These are the daily requirements of the birds. So if you are maintaining these kind of requirements of amino acids, then you can reduce the crude protein so that there will be less heat increment and less trouble of heat stress to the bird. Then increase vitamin and mineral premixes by 25%, 20%, depending upon the drop in the feed consumption. And maintain calcium intake of minimum 4.2 grams. Up to 40 weeks and 4.5 grams after 40 weeks. And available phosphorus minimum 400 mg per day per bird up to 40 weeks, and thereafter minimum 380 mg per bird per day. So these kind of things, changes in the feed or nutritional changes, will help the birds to provide, produce eggs in a better way. Then coming to the take home message or summary, management of feed, water and shed environment helps to reduce the heat stress. Make sure that the birds are eating sufficient quantities of feed and water to support the egg production. Maintain feed electrolyte and water balance, provide sufficient water, provide electrolytes in water, and maintain the feed intake by feeding more times, by feeding in the early morning or evening, and midnight feeding also if we can try. And supplementation of vitamins and minerals, which can help to reduce the heat stress. And as I told in the earlier slide, that biosecurity will help to reduce the losses, because biosecurity will prevent the diseases from away from your flock. So this was all about the summer management in commercial layers. I tried to give as much as possible, but I know that there are a few things which might have been neglected from my side. So I will try to incorporate them in the next presentation, and I will come with this. So finally, thank you friends for your kind attention, and I hope that this presentation will definitely help you to reduce the losses at your farm and to maintain the productivity of the birds at the farm. So thank you friends. During these difficult times, stay safe, stay blessed. Thank you. And we will meet again in next video with interesting topic, or you can suggest me the topic in the comments on this video, so that I accordingly I can choose the topic for my presentation. So thank you.